We are not good at speaking English, but we will do our best. Recently, we faced a problem that energy self-sufficiency is only 6% in Japan. That is why hydrogen-based fuel and energy is being popular now in Japan. Now, let's look at the process to obtain hydrogen. There are some methods to get hydrogen. For example, reaction of natural gas or petroleum with high temperature steam and taking up gas during distillation of coal, electrolyzation of salt water and electrolyzation of water by recycling energy. Thus, hydrogen is the unlimited resource of energy. Accordingly, we found two chemical reaction formulas about the hydrogen generation from our textbook. We focused on the reaction of silicon and sodium hydroxide solution. In this study, a lot of silicon is thrown away in Japan, but most of them are not used. We accidentally found waste silicon in the laboratory of our school. Our purpose of this study is to generate hydrogen using the waste silicon more safely and easily. We carried out the following experiment. First, we tested the reactivity of three kinds of alkali solution and silicon. Second, we measured the amount of hydrogen generated by reacting silicon and sodium hydroxide solution. Third, we checked the effect of silicon size on the amount of hydrogen generated. Fourth, we examined the safe method to generate hydrogen using KIPS gas generator and the operation of fuel cell. Fifth, we examined the system in which hydrogen is generated with safety. We first examined the reactivity of three kinds of alkali solution with silicon. We put silicon powder in this device. Second, we added sodium hydroxide solution, which have different concentration, aqueous ammonia, or sodium bicarbonate solution. Then, we checked whether hydrogen was generated or not and confirmed the reactivity. This is summary of our results. When we added sodium hydroxide solution, we found air bubbles after about 5 minutes. The lower the sodium hydroxide concentration, the longest time to generate air bubbles, and also the slower to generate air bubbles. By comparison, when we added aqueous ammonia, we found air bubbles after about 20 minutes, but its amount was very little. On the other hand, when we added sodium bicarbonate solution, we couldn't find air bubbles. We confirmed that all the gas generated in this experiment was hydrogen. Considering the reactivity, we found sodium hydroxide solution was the most effective. This video shows the reaction of silicon and sodium hydroxide solution. Hydrogen is generated like this. grams of silicon was reacted with sodium hydroxide solution under room temperature of 28 degrees Celsius, and the amount of hydrogen generated was examined water by water displacement. As a result, 540 meter hydrogen was generated. theoretical amount of hydrogen generated is 545 meter in the condition of using 0.31 grams of silicon. Therefore, we could get almost 100% hydrogen from silicon. We checked the reactivity of three kinds of silicon powder with sodium hydroxide solution. We found the reaction speed is faster. We found the reaction speed becomes faster when the surface area is larger. So the reaction speed is faster for this silicon powder. On the other hand, this is slow. But we found that the same amount of hydrogen was generated for all kinds of silicon. Therefore, we concluded that the amount of hydrogen generated is not affected by silicon size. So, we used this silicon powder in this study.
We made a hydrogen generating device that makes the Gibbs gas data. We put sodium hydroxide solution outside the container, and we put silicon powder inside the container. The generated hydrogen can be supplied to the fuel cell through the valve from the generator. When we open the valves, the pressure inside the container gets lower. So, sodium hydroxide solution enters inside the container. Hydrogen is generated by reacting with silicon powder. And fuel cell operates, and propeller begins to turn around. When we close the valves, the pressure inside the container gets higher. So, sodium hydroxide solution is pushed out. Because the sodium hydroxide solution doesn't come into contact with silicon powder, the generation of hydrogen stops. And the propeller stops too. Also, valves are not necessary by sharing the fuel cell. It is possible to generate hydrogen only when we are necessary by combining a fuel cell and the generator. We can put into practical use, such as introducing the small-scale power generation system as an auxiliary power source and reserve fuel of vehicles. This is the amount of solar power generation a day. It is affected by the weather and hours of daylight. But we can keep the amount of power generation constant together with silicon generation, which controls automatically. There is a high risk to solar hydrogen. And also, sodium hydroxide solution is a dangerous substance. So, we propose a new method. We generate sodium hydroxide solution for reaction of calcium hydroxide and sodium carbonate. We generate hydrogen by reacting with solution. This solution can be safely stored because they are not dangerous substances. This picture shows glasses made by heating treatment. These glasses can be recycled. We saw the method for practical use. Using containers filled with silicon powder, calcium hydroxide, sodium carbonate. We can set the number of containers depending on supplying amount of hydrogen. In this manner, it is possible to continuously generate hydrogen depending on supplying amount by by setting containers in sequence. This enables to supply power by combining a few cells.If we install the hydrogen generating device with silicon powder, calcium hydroxide, sodium carbonate, and fuel cell in the shelter, we can put into practical use as in-house power generation device. And also, if we can store in a small container that can be equipped with size in light trucks,We can carry it to our destination immediately during a disaster. These are conclusions. The hydrogen generating device can automatically control the power generation amount by combining a fuel cell. The best important thing is both conclusions. We believe thatThis device is a prime small-scale power generation system, reserve fuel of vehicles, and emergency energy in house power generation device at the shelter. Thank you for listening.
ありがとうございました。それではご質問をお受けしたいと思います。ご質問のある方、挙手をお願いいたします。ご質問のある方はいらっしゃいますでしょうか。はい、では、マイクをお持ちいたします。先日松坂先生お願いいたします。あ、松坂先生にお願いいたします。
So thank you for your talk. So I have a simple question.So, you observe the formation of dihydrogen after 5 minutes when you mix the sodium hydroxide and the silicon powder, right? So, what's happened during the first 5 minutes?
Could you say that again in Japanese?
混ぜてから水素ガスが発生するまでは時間差がありますね。混ぜた途端に反応が始まるんじゃなくて、混ぜてからしばらくは何にも見た目起こらないで、何分か経つとやぶらガスが出てきますね。じゃあ混ぜてからガスが発生するまでの間ってのは、一見何事も起こってないようですけれども、何かが起こってきっとガスが発生するようになるんですね。何が起こってるんでしょうね。例えばこんなこと考えられないかなとかっていうことありませんか。
シリコンの表面が先に反応してくるので、最初の、気泡が見られないときは表面だけの反応ですので、気泡が見られなくて、だんだん時間が経つにつれて内部の方にまで浸透してきて水素が発生している。そして気泡がたくさん出てきて、水素が出てきて気泡が見えるのではないかなと思います。
最初はちょっとは発生してるんだけど、目で見えないぐらいの量であって、後からだんだん増える量が増えてくるから、たくさん泡が見えるんだっていう理解でよろしいですか。
はい、そのように考えておりますが、少し勉強不足でしたので、またこれからの課題としてそちらの方も考えていきたいと思います。
ありがとうございました。
ありがとうございます。
ありがとうございます。それではお時間となりましたので以上とさせていただきます。飯浜工業高等専門学校の皆さんでした。ありがとうございました。